When we open some portal or website, we will see a messaging area which will resolve our questions. Have you ever thought how these message bots were created and working in the background? It's nothing but a simple service provided by most of the cloud technologies. Today, in this session, we will create a chatbot in AWS Cloud by using Amazon Lex service. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. The use case is AWS Lex chatbot to fetch the data from database. The prerequisites are basic AWS knowledge, Lambda, Python, database, which is DynamoDB. So without any further delay, let's look at the demo. I'm in my AWS console, expand the all services and select Amazon Lex under machine learning. The Amazon Lex console will look like this for the first time. So Amazon Lex is an AI-based service which will be used to create chatbot applications. Let's get started. Amazon Lex has some sample bots like book trip, order flowers, schedule appointment. I am selecting custom bot to make this from scratch. I'll select custom bot and I'll fill out the details. Bot name as account balance. Language, I will select English US. The output voice, I will not select anything because it's a chatbot. The session timeout is ideal time of our bot. It's 4 minutes. I'll leave everything as default except the child production one. I'll select no. Then create. So after that, it will ask me to create an intent. Before that, we will look at some components of your bot. So those are intents. Intent is nothing but a particular goal that the user wants to achieve, like book trip. Utterances. Utterances are some queries asked by users. Slots, prompts, fulfillment. So I'll select on create intent. There are three different ways to create intent. I'll select create intent. So the intent name is account balance inquiry. Let's add it. The intent is shown here, account balance inquiry, and I will give some sample utterances. Like I want to know my account balance. Let's click on the plus icon. The intent will be shown here. Get me my account balance. Account balance. Then press enter or press plus button, then balance. Let's fill out the slats. So the prompt is nothing but the question which is asked by the bot, like please enter your account number. And then slot type is a number because our account number will be a number. So I'll search number here and I will select Amazon number. And the name, which act like a variable name, like account number. Let's add it. And you can select whether it is a required or not. And fulfillment. Fulfillment is nothing but the business logic which will be running, like Lambda function. So here the Lambda function is account balance. Let's save the intent and build it. So the build process will take some couple of minutes and you can edit in the middle also. The build process will take some couple of minutes. So let's wait to complete. So the build is still in progress and let's wait for some more time. The build is successful and it is ready to test. Let's test it by giving some by entering I want to know my account balance. I want to know my account balance and press enter. The bot will ask me to enter the account number, which is the prompt I have given in the before. So I will enter 1234 as my account number. The bot will say, "Hello Venkatesh Kodumuri, you have $10 million in your account." So which got fetched from my DB. So let's add one more intent, which is greetings. So greetings and add. Now let me add some more utterances like hi, hello, WhatsApp, all those things. Like hello, WhatsApp. And I don't want to waste your time by seeing all my typing. So I have added all the utterances, and I will add some responses like hi, welcome to VK Banks, and I have added the response as hi, welcome to VK Banks, I am VK, how can I help you today? And one more message I am adding is, you can ask your queries like account balance, and I will add it as a response message. And before building it, save the intent, otherwise the changes will not be affected. Let's build it. The build process will take some time. Oh, we got an error, which is like, yeah, we should not give question marks in the utterances. So let's build it. The build process will take couple of minutes. Yeah, the build is ready, and let's test it by giving hi. Yeah, it has given me the response like hello, welcome to VK Banks, I am VK, how can I help you today? You can ask me like account balance. Let's ask account balance. Yeah, it asked me the prompt like please enter your account number. I am giving 1234, and it has given me the result as expected, $10 million. And let me ask, I want to know my account balance. So the Lex will ask me my account number. I'm giving 9898 as my account number. So it has given me, hello Steve, you have $10,000 in your account. So let's test the ML. I'm entering spelling mistake like account. So if you observe that, you can find it. Please enter it got the thing right, and it asked me the account number. I'm entering 6666. So it didn't find the account number in my DB, so it is giving the prompt to contact customer care agent, and let's publish it. And let's give a alias name, which is dev, and let's add tags, which is like version 1, and let me publish that. The publishing will take some couple of minutes. Let's wait for the publish is ready, and the chatbot is ready to deployment. Amazon provides a good documentation to further steps like how to connect it to your mobile apps and some services like Facebook Messenger, Slack, Twilio, Kik. Let me close this and let's look at the backend details, which is DynamoDB and account balance Lambda. So here I am using Python to fetch the data from DynamoDB. So I have used Python Boto 3, and I have imported DynamoDB, and I am fetching the details from the intent, I mean the event account number, and I'm call if the intent name is account balance, I'll be calling balance inquiry by passing account number as a parameter. So the balance inquiry function will look like this. So here I'm calling a method getItem by two particular database, which is customer details, by passing account number which we got from the event. So I have defined a variable which is key, and I'm checking whether the key, the particular item key, is present in the response or not. If the value is yes, then the account number will be fetched from the response which we got from the database, which is DynamoDB. Name and balance will be fetched out, and the message will be like, "Hello, the name which we got from the response, and you have this many dollars in your account." Basically, in Python, this particular sentence will be a tuple, and I'm converting it into string. So the result will be given to the method, and the result format should be like this because the Lex should understand your response. So I'm delivering the content as a message variable, which is here. And I'm returning the result. The result will be given back to Lex from here. So if the result does not have the item key, then it will say like, "Sorry, I cannot find your details in our records. Please contact our customer care center like this number." And I'm sending the message to the Lex as a result. I'll be giving the GitHub link in the description. DynamoDB will look like this, the customer details. So here, customer details is the table name, and account number is 1234. My name is Venkatesh Kodumuri, and the balance, then 9898 account number, 10,000, and Steve. Like the video, please like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Venkatesh Kodumuri. Thank you.